Father, we bless your name this very day.
Baba wa fi ibukun foruko yin lojo oni.
We praise you because of your word.
A fi yin fun yin nitori oro
yin. Which you always give us in wisdom and in love.
Ti en fun wa ninu ogbon ati ife yin.
Which you give us so that you can prepare us for heaven.
Ti en fun wa ke ba le pese wa sile fun oro.
We pray that this very day what we share from the word of God will be of benefit to every one of us in Jesus' name.
A gbadura yin pe ohun ti a o se alabafin ninu oro yin loni yo se olukuluku wa nire ni oruko Jesu.
Guide us into the rivers of living water in your word. Refresh us, enlighten us, teach us, and train us in the way we ought to go. In Jesus' name we pray. And God has so much for us in the word of God to make marriage a glorious possibility. And yet human beings have made it something bad and negative, something that, you know, makes you to suffer. Instead of the many promises and privileges we have in the Bible concerning marriage and the family, the source or the essence or the center of marriage with many people is just their problem.
Dípò àwọn líle tí àti àwọn ìbùkún àti àwọn ìlérí ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ tó yí ìgbéyàwó ká tó yẹ fún wa láti rí inú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run, ṣùgbọ́n wàhálà àti ìpọ́njú àti làásìgbò ni àwọn èèyàn bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí rí.
And today we're talking on a major problem in marriage.
Lónìí a ti ń sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ìṣòro kan tí ó ṣe tí ó lágbára lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ nínú ìgbéyàwó.
When a man and a woman come together in matrimony, in wedlock or marriage.
Nígbà tí ọkùnrin àti obìnrin kan tí wọ́n bá ti di ọkọ àti aya nínú ìgbéyàwó.
There are many things that bring problems into the marriage.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan ló máa ń mú wàhálà wá sínú ìgbéyàwó.
But the number one, the central problem,
ìṣòro tí ó ga jùlọ níbẹ̀,
is how to deal with money.
Òun náà ni bí a ṣe ń bójútó owó.
And so this morning we're looking at the message, money and marriage.
Nítorí náà ní àárọ̀ yìí a ń ṣe àyẹ̀wò ìwàásù tó dúró lórí owó àti ìgbéyàwó.
It can be a blessing if we have money.
Ó lè jẹ́ ìbùkún bí a bá lówó.
And yet it can be something that is not blessed but something very harmful if we don't know what to do with the money.
Síbẹ̀ ó lè jẹ́ nǹkan tí kò mú ìbùkún lọ́wọ́ ṣùgbọ́n nǹkan tí ó léwu bí a bá lówó náà ṣùgbọ́n bí a kò bá bá bí a lè.
Many things cause problems in families in relation to money.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan ni ó ń fa wàhálà sínú ẹbí nítorí owó.
One, it could be because of an ambition on the side of the man or the woman to accumulate wealth.
Ìkíní ó lè jẹ́ ìlépa ní ìhà tí ọkùnrin tàbí ti obìnrin láti kó ọrọ̀ jọ.
So the man is always outside working and, you know, robbing the family of fellowship and love and time and affection because he's always outside looking for money. He has an ambition to accumulate very much.
Nítorí náà ọkùnrin yóò lè wà lóde kó jẹ́ pé kò ní àkókò, kò ní ìfẹ́, kò ní wákàtí kankan láti lò láti ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú ìyàwó rẹ̀ àti àwọn ọmọ nínú ilé, ṣùgbọ́n nítorí pé ó ní ìlépa láti kó ọrọ̀ jọ yóò wà lóde yóò sì máa lépa owó.
Number two, it may be because of pressure from other people just for him to have more and more and more.
Èkejì, ó lè jẹ́ ìyọlẹ́nu láti ọ̀dọ̀ àwọn ẹlòmíràn kí ó bà lè máa ní sí, kó máa ní sí, kó sà máa ní sí ṣá.
Number three, what sometimes causes problem in families is because there is envy, because he wants to live, the man wants to live the lifestyle of a Mr. Smith or Mr. Jones somewhere.
Ohun kẹta tó tún máa ń fa wàhálà tàbí ìyọnu nínú ẹbí òun náà ni pé ó lè jẹ́ pé ọkùnrin òun fẹ́ gbé ìgbésí ayé rẹ̀ bíi ti ọ̀gbẹ́ni Lágbájá tàbí ọ̀gbẹ́ni Làkáṣègbè.
Or she's a woman that is always looking at another woman and she wants to spend money like they are spending money.
Tàbí obìnrin ni ó ń wo obìnrin mìíràn tí òun sì fẹ́ máa náwó bí àwọn pẹ̀lú ti náwó.
In Psalm 73 verses 2 and 3.
Nínú orin Dáfídì orí kẹtàléní àádọ́rin ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì àti ìkẹta.
Psalm 73 verses 2 and 3.
Orin Dáfídì orí kẹtàléláàádọ́rin ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì
àti ìkẹta. But as for me, my feet were almost gone, my steps were well nigh slipped, for I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked.
Ṣùgbọ́n bí ó ṣe ti èmi ni ẹsẹ̀ mi fẹ́rẹ̀ yẹ̀ tán, ìrìn mi sì fẹ́rẹ̀ yọ tán. Nítorí tí èmi ṣe ìlara sí àwọn aṣebépé nígbà tí mo rí àlàáfíà àwọn ènìyàn búburú.
And so it brings problems to the family when we do not just sit down together and discuss how we want to plan and budget and spend money, but we're always looking at another family to lead us in the way we ought to spend money.
Nítorí náà ó máa mú wàhálà àti ìṣòro wá sínú ẹbí nígbà tí a kò bá jọ jókòó, kí a jọ jíròrò, kí a sì jọ gbèrò papọ̀ bí nǹkan tí a ó ṣe nípa owó àti bí a ó ṣe náà
Another reason for problems in money management or money finance management in the family is because of pride.
Oh, mira to ma fa wahala ti soro ninu ebi o na ni nipa ti eto tuna wo ebi o na ni igberaga.
The desire to feel bigger than everybody around.
Lati le ma fe lati ma fe ju awon to wa laye ka lo.
And in Proverbs chapter 16.
Ninu we owo rikerin dilogun.
We're told in verse 5.
Aso fun ninu ese ikarun.
Everyone that is proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord.
Olukuluku eniyan ti o gberaga li aya irira ni loju Oluwa.
No hand join in hand, they shall not be unpunished.
Bi ati le fi owo so owo.
Verse 18, pride goeth before destruction, and an haughty spirit before a fall. Verse 19, better it is to be of an humble spirit with the lowly than to divide the spoil with the proud. I told you that problems come into marriage on the money spending because of one ambition to accumulate.
Mo ti so fun yin pe owo ma mu wahala wa sinu ebi ni igba miran ikini nitori ilepa lati fe ku
ara. Because of pressure to keep on having more, there is a possessive attitude on the family.
Ekeje iyolenu latode wipe ki eniyan to le ma ni si elesin mu wahala wa sinu ebi.
Three, because of envy, wanting to be like the other family.
Eketa nitori ilara mo fe da.
For because of pride, wanting to feel bigger than everybody around. Spending lavishly only to make yourself feel big. Number 5, because of fear of the future. No, people are concerned to save for the future and they are not spending for today. The man is, desire. So that in my old age I will have money and it's not spending so that it will live till old age. Number 6, we have problems because there is a basic fundamental disagreement between the husband and the wife on how the money in the family ought to be spent.
Ekefa nitori pe ede ayede ati aifo nsokan laarin oko ati aya nipa bi won o se nawo nbe laarin won.
There are different perspectives about money.
Bi won se won se wo owo yato sira won.
Different sets of priorities in the family.
Bi awon kan ti o gbe to to ga ninu okan won yato ninu ebi.
Different interests in the family.
Awon kan ti won fe o yato si ara won.
And therefore they have different ideas on where the money ought to go. And because of that, there's always a disagreement and argument on how money should be spent in the family. Number 7, the reason why we have problems in the family concerning money. Selfishness. Caring for self and buying things for self without considering other members of the family. Number 8, overindulgence and covetousness. Spending money on things that don't have any lasting value on the family. Expensive entertainment. Only to impress people when he is not impressing his wife and children, not spending on them. You know, in Proverbs chapter 21 verse 17, we're told this, and it's a word of caution, a word of warning, that you're spending your family after you've, you know, given your tithe and your offering to God. Your family is number one. And in Proverbs chapter 21 verse 17, he that loveth pleasure shall be a poor man. He that loveth wine and oil shall not be rich. And so you see, these problems are caused in family. As we have more reasons to give you why we have problems in our family on spending. Number 9, the reason we have problems in spending is because of what we call impulsive buying, buying on emotion. Buy now and think later. You don't think at all before the buying. No plan, no budget. You just put money in your pocket. And then you are going outside. Then you see something. Your emotions rise up. And you feel, I must get that thing. You buy now and think later. That's what we call impulsive buying. Number 10, the reason we have problems with money in the family. Shaky and shady investments. You see the program, a project of getting rich quick. When a friend comes to you and he says, if we take that business and we do it, you'll get money in 1 year. And so all your money, you invest it upon something that will not bring any results out. They don't pay off, that is, they are not profitable at all. And the reason you have lost your money that way is because you do it now and then you are thinking later of the consequences. See, in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 20, a faithful man shall abound with blessings, but he that maketh haste to be rich shall not be innocent.
Olóòótọ́ ènìyàn yóò pọ̀ fún ìbùkún, ṣùgbọ́n ẹni tí ó kánjú láti là kí yóò ṣe aláìjìyà.
Verse 22.
Ẹsẹ̀ kejìlélógún.
He that hasteth to be rich has an evil eye, and considereth not that poverty shall come upon him.
Ẹni tí ó kánjú àti là, ó lé ojú ìlara, kò sì rò pé òṣì ń bọ̀ wá sá òun.
Reason number 11 why we have problems in families on money.
Èrèdí kẹwàá tí a fi ní ìṣòro nínú ẹbí nítorí owó.
Materialistic love, having love for material things that may not be useful at all to the family.
Ìfẹ́ láti kó àwọn ohun ìní jọ tí ó jẹ́ pé kò lè wúlò fún ẹbí.
You don't think of the value and the use of the thing you are buying.
O ronú nípa pàtàkì àti ìlò nǹkan náà tí òun kówó
lé. You just spend money on them, put money on them without thinking of the essential things the family would need.
Wà kàn máa kó lé àwọn nǹkan wọ̀nyí lórí lásán láì ronú nípa àwọn nǹkan tó ṣe pàtàkì gan tí ẹbí nílò.
Number 12, we call it unwise purchase.
Ìkejìlá à ń pè ní rírà pẹ̀lú ìwà ọ̀mùgọ̀.
Look at me here. You see, advertisers, they are taught to get money out of your pocket. You see those billboards on the road, whenever you are going on the way, you see a large signboard. The writers have studied psychology. They have studied how to influence the mind of man to take a decision which they want, not a decision that will profit you. Why you read those billboards? There be something within you to tell you, go and buy that thing. Unwise purchase. Do you know something? When you go to the Kingswells or Chalaran's or any shop, understand that those people are trained in getting money out of your pocket. In the arrangement of the things they have in the shop, to attract your attention.
When
you get into the shop, especially a supermarket, now you bought the things you really need, the things you really want. And you, when you put that one, you put those things in the tray, and you are coming very near where the cashier is to pay your money. They arrange some other things there in a very nice way. Things that you really don't need. But the arrangement is so attractive. Because they have used the psychology of selling. You say, wait, I've not finished. I must take this thing. You take that, the, you know, the paper they put on the bottle, they so make it very look nice, and you know it's not the paper you are going to eat, it's the sin inside. And because of the colorful paper, which is just the method of advertisement, we make unwise purchases. Even the people that are not educated in psychology, you go to the market, and as you are going along, the woman selling gari will taste it and say, this is wonderful. I've never seen this like before. And then as you are going, madam, come now. Your husband will eat this one, now one for you. That's not what you came to the market to buy. But because this woman can talk, trained in experience, to get money from your pocket, you say, let me buy a little. And then you buy. Before you get to where you see what you really want, somebody else said, this has just come. And you know these young boys that are selling clothes for children, clothes for adults, and clothes for everybody, they dangle it like this and tell you, mama, you never got this one, you need this. Now, because of that, without thinking and making your plan on spending, you just buy and buy and buy. Now, money has finished. Number 13, why we suffer? Well, we have problems in spending money. I call it saving and suffering. You put the money somewhere. You like a bulging bank account. But you are suffering. You are not spending the money. The money is supposed to be spent. Spent wisely and reasonably. Number 14. Loving money more than your wife. You marry your money, you divorce your wife. You keep your money to your bosom, near your heart, and then your wife can stay afar off. You carry your money on your shoulder, you never carry your children on the shoulder. You watch your money, you protect your money, you never watch your wife and protect your wife. Your money is becoming fat, your wife is becoming lean. That's why we have problems in money. And in the marriage, if your money does not grow lean and your wife grow fat, you have a problem. If it's your children and your wife that is getting lean and then your money is getting fat, that's a problem. That means you are overrating money above everything in life, above everybody in life. You are trusting your money more than you trust God. Reason number 15, why we have problems in money. In managing money in the family. Squandering money. Foolish spending. Uncontrolled spending that has no plan. Number 16. Carnal, sinful spending on women outside, and the only woman inside has no money to spend. That's why we have problems. When you put all your money, you put it on children outside, women outside, things and people outside, and the people living with you, they have no food to eat. Reason number 17, why we have problems in spending money. Operating habitually on the credit system, that is on borrowing. So that every month when you get your money, you are paying out debt every time. You are never free. Now number 18. unwise independent spending. Independent, that means you never discuss it with your wife, with your husband. The money comes in without any discussion, any agreement. You are just spending.
Number 19,
failure to discuss finance with your partner. That's why we have problems in our spending money. The husband and the wife, they never talk about it. They never sit down to say, this is the amount that has come in. How do we spend? Reason number 20. Failure to learn from your past mistakes, sin, the wrong use and the wrong spending of money. You see, life is a school. And our mistakes are supposed to teach us to become wiser for tomorrow. Now, I want to help you to see whether you have a problem or not. Do you have a Bible to write with you? If you have a Bible, can you raise it up and let me see? This is a good class. Now, in all the questions I'll be asking now, this is personal to you. Between you and your wife, you write yes or no. Now, I'm to help you to make you see how you have been spending money. Now, when I read out question number one, you think about your life, you think about your family, you think about your spending, then you write yes or no. Number one, do I owe for small day-to-day expenditure like rice, like garri, like little things like omo, like soap? Do I owe money to the people who are selling on small day-to-day expenditure? Don't let anybody spy what you are writing. Now, number two, do I have to borrow money to pay for fixed expenses like my house rent, instrumental paying, or paying back my debt? The things that are fixed, I know I have to spend money on. Do I have to borrow money to pay for them? Yes or no? Number three, am I unable to say how much I spend? That is how much money I need each month for my regular expenses. If somebody just asks me, how much do you spend every month? Do you really need every month to meet your normal expenses? Do I know it? Number four, do I shuffle funds around? That is, I originally set a particular amount of money to buy this thing, and then in the middle of the month, I just change my mind and I spend it on another thing. Do I shuffle funds around using cash originally set aside for other purposes? Yes or no? Number five, do I now borrow money to buy some items which in the past I could buy freely without borrowing money? Yes or no? Number six, am I taking new loan to pay old loan? That is, I owe Peter money. And Peter is saying, bring money. I go to Paul to borrow money from Paul to pay the money I owe Peter. Do I do that? Yes or no? Number seven, do I find it necessary to depend on extra income to make ends meet?
ǹjẹ́ mo rí pé ó ṣe pàtàkì fún mi láti wá ọ̀nà mìíràn tí owó yóò ti máa gbà wọlé láti lè bá àwọn ẹ̀ní mi pàdé.
Number 8. Have I been repeatedly unsuccessful in saving for the near future needs?
Ǹjẹ́ nígbà gbogbo ni mo ti máa ń kùnà nípa àti fowó pamọ́ fún àwọn ẹ̀ní ọjọ́ ọ̀la?
That is, I need some furniture at home.
Èyí ni pé mo nílò àwọn àga ìjòkó.
I need a fan at home.
Mo nílò fáànù nílé.
I need some other necessary things at home.
Mo nílò àwọn nǹkan mìíràn tó ṣe pàtàkì nílé.
And I'm almost always saying, I will save for it, I will save for it, I will save for it, but it has never been possible for me.
Nígbà gbogbo ni mo sì wípé màá fi owó pamọ́ fún, màá fi owó pamọ́ fún, kò sì tíì ṣeé ṣe fún mi nígbà.
So have I been repeatedly unsuccessful in saving money for these future needs?
Ṣé mo ti ń kùnà nípa àti fowó pamọ́ fún àwọn àìní ọjọ́ ọ̀la?
Number 9.
Ẹ̀kẹ́tàn.
Have I and my wife been having frequent arguments based on money problems?
Ǹjẹ́ èmi pẹ̀lú ìyàwó mi ti máa ní èdè àìyedè lórí ọ̀rọ̀ owó nígbà gbogbo mi?
Yes or no?
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni tàbí.
Number 10.
Ẹ̀kẹ́wàá.
Do I have to engage in suspicious, dishonest business so as to be able to provide for myself and the family?
Ǹjẹ́ mo ní láti lọ lọ́wọ́ nínú iṣẹ́ tó jẹ́ tó lè mú kí àwọn ẹlòmíràn máa fura sí mi tí bá lè pèsè fún ẹbí mi bí?
Number 11.
Ìkọkànlá.
Does my list of things I've just got to have now keep on growing no matter how many of the items I buy?
Ǹjẹ́ àwọn àkọsílẹ̀ àwọn nǹkan tí mo nílò nísinsìnyí ǹjẹ́ ó lè mú kí àwọn kan máa dàgbà sí bí ó ti wù kí ó rí kí máa ra àwọn kan náà?
That is, you know, every time I just tell myself, I need this, I need this, I need this, I need this, and no matter how many of those things I buy, the things I say I need, they keep on growing. If I need 10 things and I buy 3 out of them, I see that I need 12. Now, if I buy 5 again, I see that I need 13. Does my need of things I've just got to have, does that need keep growing no matter how many things I've bought? Yes or no?
Ǹjẹ́ àwọn nǹkan tí mo wí pé mo nílò ǹjọ́ bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ń dàgbà sí iye àwọn nǹkan yòówù kí ní fún àpẹẹrẹ wípé bóyá mo nílò nǹkan mẹ́wàá mo ra mẹ́ta nínú rẹ̀ bí mo ṣe ń ra mẹ́ta mo tún rí pé méjìlá ni mo tún nílò tí àwọn nǹkan bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ń dàgbà sí ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀ ni tàbí bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́.
Are you writing down the answer?
Ṣé ẹ ń kọ ìdáhùn sílẹ̀?
Personal answer.
Ìdáhùn tirẹ̀ gan.
You are wonderful.
Ẹ jẹ́ àgbà
yẹn. Number 12. Do I find myself hesitant and unwilling to pay my tithe from my income or to give anybody in need any amount of money? Yes or no?
Ǹjẹ́ mo jẹ́ ẹni tó máa ń lọ́ra àti ẹni tó jẹ́ aláfara nípa àti san ìdá mẹ́wàá mi tàbí láti ran ẹlòmíràn lọ́wọ́ láti bá ìní rẹ̀ pàdé bí? Bẹ́ẹ̀ni tàbí bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́.
I've asked you 12 questions.
Mo ti bi léèrè ìbéèrè méjìlá.
And some of the answers are yes and some are no.
Àwọn ìdáhùn nínú wọn sì jẹ́ ìmíràn nínú wọn jẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ ni àwọn mìíràn jẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́.
Look at your paper, am I right?
Wo ìwé rẹ.
Some answers are yes, some answers are no.
Àwọn ìdáhùn mìíràn jẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ ni àwọn mìíràn jẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́.
Am I right?
Ṣé bẹ́ẹ̀ ni?
The ones for yes, look at it very well, they are more than the ones for no.
Eléyìí tó jẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ó ju bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́ lọ.
Don't let anybody spy your paper.
Má ṣe jẹ́ kẹ́nikẹ́ni yọjú wo ìwé rẹ.
Now the answers for yes are more, am I right?
Ìdáhùn fún bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ó pọ̀ jù.
Okay, if the answers for yes are more, that means you have problems.
Bí ìdáhùn rẹ tí bẹ́ẹ̀ ni bá jẹ́ bí bẹ́ẹ̀ ni tó bá pọ̀ nínú ìdáhùn rẹ, èyí ni pé o ní wàhálà.
That means you do not know how to spend very well.
Èyí ni pé o kò mọ bí a ti náwó dáadáa.
It's a test I've given you to make you know how people just spend.
Ó jẹ́ ìdánwò tí mo ti ṣe fún ọ láti jẹ́ kí o mọ̀ bí àwọn èèyàn ti náwó.
And people do not know how to control their spending.
Àwọn ènìyàn wọn ò sì mọ bí wọ́n ṣe lè kó ìnáwó wọn ní ìjánu.
And money makes them unhappy and sad instead of helping them in the family.
Owó ti ń bà wọ́n nínú jọ́ ń dorí wọn kọdù kàkà kí ó máa ràn wọ́n lọ́wọ́ nínú ẹbí wọn.
You know, some people say, if I have more money, all my problems are solved.
Àwọn
My brother, my sister, remember when you were level 04?
Arákùnrin arábìnrin mi rántí ìgbà tí ó wà ní ìgbésẹ̀ kẹrin nínú.
Money was never sufficient.
Owó tó ní.
They promoted you to level 06.
Wọ́n tún gbé ọga sí ìgbésẹ̀ kẹfà.
Did it become sufficient?
Ǹjẹ́ ó tún.
No. Rárá. They promoted you to level 08.
Wọ́n tún gbé ọ ní ìṣísẹ̀ kẹjọ sí.
Did it become sufficient?
Ǹjẹ́ ó tún.
No, you go to level 09.
Wọ́n tún gbé ọ sókè, ó tún dé
ìgbésẹ̀ kẹfà. Was it sufficient?
Ǹjẹ́ ó tún tó.
No. Listen to me. More money has a way of generating more spending. When more money comes in, there will be more things to buy. Am I right? They are never sufficient. The money is never sufficient. And it is because we have no wisdom and understanding on how to control our spending. I've titled that section 1, Faults and Failures. Now you see, we have our faults and our failures in in spending money in the family.
Ani ebi ati ifunawa ninu ninawo ninu ebi wa.
I'm going to number two, which is faith for funds.
Mo n lo si ipakeji ti se igbagbo fun imowo wole.
Now you see, to be able to have money to spend, we need to believe God.
Lati le lowo lati na ninu ebi wa, ani lati le gba Olorun gbo.
That God will supply.
Ipe Olorun yo pese.
And in Proverbs chapter 10.
Inu iwe owe ori kewa.
Proverbs chapter 10.
Owe ori kewa.
Reading from verse 4. He becometh poor that dealeth with a slack hand, but the hand of the diligent maketh rich.
Ẹni tó bá de ọwọ́ àdìsálákà, ṣùgbọ́n ọwọ́ àwọn alákan ní mú ọlá wá.
That's how to get rich.
Bí a ṣe lọ́rọ̀ nìyí.
To become diligent in your work.
Láti jẹ́ alákan lẹ́nu iṣẹ́ rẹ.
Faithful in service.
Láti jẹ́ olóòótọ́ nínú iṣẹ́.
Fervent in the place of your work.
Láti jẹ́ ẹni tó jálábá níbi iṣẹ́ rẹ.
But if you are lazy and indolent and, you know, unwilling to work, of course you will not be able to have.
Ṣùgbọ́n bí o bá ní ọ̀lẹ́ àti ọ́ ní tí ọwọ́ rẹ̀ ń dilẹ̀ wá rí wípé o kò ní le ní nǹkan kan.
In verse 5.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún.
He that gathereth in summer is a wise son, but he that sleepeth in harvest is a son that causeth shame.
Ẹni tí ó bá kójọ ní ìgbà ẹ̀rùn lé ọlọ́gbọ́n ọmọ, ṣùgbọ́n ẹni tí ó bá ń sùn ní ìgbà ẹ̀rùn lé ọmọ tí dójú
sí. Blessings are upon the head of the judge.
Ìbùkún wà lé orí olódodo.
But violence covers the mouth of the wicked.
Ṣùgbọ́n ìwà agbára ni yóò bá ẹnu èèyàn búburú.
In chapter 12 verse 14.
Ẹsẹ̀.
Chapter 12, verse 14. A man shall be satisfied with good by the fruit of his mouth, but the recompense of a man's hand shall be rendered unto him. 12:14. In chapter 13 of Proverbs, verse 11. Wealth gotten by vanity shall be diminished, but he that gathereth by labor shall increase.
Ọ̀rọ̀ tí a fi ìwà asán ní yóò fà sẹ́yìn, ṣùgbọ́n ẹni tí ó fi iṣẹ́ ọwọ́ kójọ ni yóò máa pọ̀ sí i.
2 Thessalonians chapter 3.
Thessalonica kejì orí kẹta.
From verse 8.
Láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà.
Now we command you, brethren, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye withdraw yourselves from every brother that walketh disorderly, not after the tradition which he received of all.
Àwa sì pàṣẹ fún yín ara. Lé orúkọ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa, kí ẹ̀yin kí ó yẹra kúrò lọ́dọ̀ olúkúlùkù arákùnrin tí ń rìn ségesège, tí kìí ṣe gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìlànà tí wọ́n gbà ti gbà lọ́wọ́ wa.
Verse 10.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹwàá.
For even when we were with you, this we commanded you, that if any would not work, neither should he eat.
Nítorí nígbà tí àwa tilẹ̀ wà pẹ̀lú yín, èyí lè àwa pa láṣẹ fún yín pé bí ẹnikẹ́ni kò bá fẹ́ ṣiṣẹ́, kí ó má ṣe jẹun.
You see, you ought to find work.
Ó yẹ fún ọ láti wáṣẹ́
sí. And have good labor.
Tí ó sì ṣe làálàá.
Don't be in a type of dubious, dishonest business.
Má ṣe wà nínú iṣẹ́ tí yóò máa mú kí àwọn èèyàn fura sí ọ.
By the work you do, God will provide for you.
Nípa iṣẹ́ tí òun ṣe, Ọlọ́run yóò pèsè fún
ọ. There are many types of work you can do.
Oríṣiríṣi iṣẹ́ ló wà tí o lè ṣe.
Now you ought to find out with your friends or from your friends and, you know, discuss together.
Ó tún yẹ fún ọ láti wádìí lọ́dọ̀ àwọn ọ̀rẹ́ rẹ kí ẹjọ́ sọ̀rọ̀.
That's why we're in a fellowship.
Ìdí rẹ̀ ni tí a fi wà ní ìdàpọ̀.
If you have a problem on getting job, be free and discuss with, you know, brothers and sisters who are here with us.
Bí o bá ní wàhálà nípa àtiríṣẹ́ ṣe, ìwọ tí o kàn ká kí o sì bèrè lọ́wọ́ àwọn arákùnrin àtàrábìnrin
wa. Our brothers and sisters there are wonderful.
Àwọn arákùnrin àtàrábìnrin wa ní ìwọ jẹ́ àmì.
There are times they know that there are vacancies and there are places of work. They come to tell the ministry, we announce it, and many people have got jobs that way.
Ìgbà mìíràn wà tó jẹ́ pé wọ́n rí pé àyè iṣẹ́ sí sílẹ̀ ní ibi iṣẹ́ wọn, wọn a sì wá sọ fún iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ ní ìyá ọ̀fìlọ̀ nípasẹ̀ báyọ̀ ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ èèyàn ló ti rí.
Now apart from getting money through the labor of your hand.
Yàtọ̀ sí rírí owó nípa làálàá ọwọ́.
God also provides in various ways.
Ọlọ́run ti máa ń pèsè ní oríṣiríṣi ọ̀nà.
In Philippians chapter 4 verse 19.
Nínú ìwé Philippi orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ kọkàndínlógún.
But God shall supply all your need according to his riches, not your riches, his riches in glory by Christ Jesus.
Ṣùgbọ́n Ọlọ́run mi yóò pèsè ní kíkún fún gbogbo àìní gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀ kì í ṣe ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀ nínú ògo nínú Kristi Jesu.
In James chapter 4 verse 2.
Jacobu orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì.
God provides for those who will pray and pray in faith.
Ọlọ́run pèsè fún àwọn tí yóò gbàdúrà tí wọ́n sì gbàdúrà pẹ̀lú ìgbàgbọ́.
In James 4:2, ye lust and have not, ye kill and desire to have and cannot obtain, ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because ye ask not.
Ẹ̀yin ń fẹ́ kò sì ní, ẹ̀yin ń pa, ẹ sì ń ṣe ìlara, ẹ kò sì lè ní.
You know, if you depend upon God, God will make it all sufficient for you to spend and for your family to spend. We are told in chapter 8 of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verses 17 and 18. And thou say in thine heart, my power and the might of mine hand has gotten me this
wealth.
But thou shalt remember. But thou shalt remember. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God. For it is He that giveth thee power to get well, that He may establish His covenant that is well unto thy fathers, as it is this day.
Kí o kí ó lè fi ìdí májẹ̀mú rẹ̀ sí ó búra fún àwọn bàbá rẹ̀ kalẹ̀.
God has promised that He will provide for us. And in Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 19. Ecclesiastes 5:19. Every man also to whom God has given riches and wealth, and has given him power to eat thereof, and to take his portion, and to rejoice in his labor, this is the gift of God.
Bí Ọlọ́run bá fi ọrọ̀ fún ẹnikẹ́ni tí ó sì fún ilé agbára àti jẹ nínú rẹ̀ àti láti mú ìpín rẹ̀ àti láti yọ nínú làálàá rẹ̀, èyí pẹ̀lú ẹ̀bùn Ọlọ́run ni.
So God has the power, the knowledge, the provision to give us the supply to our needs.
Nítorí náà Ọlọ́run ní ipá àti agbára àti òye láti lè fún wa ní àwọn àìní wa.
Now that you have money does not mean your family will be happy.
Wípé olówó ní ipò túmọ̀ sí pé inú ẹbí rẹ̀
yóò. If you don't know how to spend that money.
Bí o kò bá mọ bí wà á ti ná owó náà.
That you have money does not mean that your children will be cared for.
Bí olówó yìí kò túmọ̀ sí pé àwọn ọmọ rẹ yóò ní ìtọ́jú.
If you don't know how to spend that money on the family and on the children.
Bí o kò bá mọ bí a ti ná owó yìí lé orí àwọn ẹbí àti àwọn ọmọ rẹ.
I'm concluding with steps to financial freedom.
Mo ń parí rẹ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn ìgbésẹ̀ sínú.
You want to be free from the anxiety and the worry and the problems that money brings in the family. You want to understand how you can spend in a wise way. In a way that the money is not a problem to you, but a blessing, a privilege for you to have. Now keep your attention clear. And focus on me here, because I'm giving you 4 points on how to have financial freedom. How your money will be your servant and not your master. How you will use your money, but your money will not use you. How your money will make you fat as the money is growing lean. Not how you will be lean and your money will be growing fat. How you will not come under the curse because of the load of money, but you'll come under the blessing of God. Now that you've got the money by working, you receive the salary at the end of the month, or you receive your pay because you are trading and now you are getting money. Now for those of us who have not married yet, all these things are very useful to you. But I'm now talking particularly to those who are married. Step number one. Settle your financial differences between the husband and the wife. Because financial differences is one of the biggest causes of disharmony and problem in marriage. So step number one, sit down to discuss financial matters together. Poor communication leads to financial foolishness. When you sit down to talk about money, about spending, what are you going to say? Talk about your priorities for spending. Talk about the necessity to save a little of what comes in. Pinpoint any area you have recently spent foolishly. Agree on some rules in the family whereby you'll be spending for better family budget.
Hey,
since you have married, you have never done that, you should do that today. If you never talk about money, that's why the problem is there. If most of you have never sat down to discuss your priorities, your experiences, your foolishness, your mistakes, and you know your ways of spending money, there will be mistakes more that will come into the family. If there is no money, sit down and talk about it. If there is little money, be frank, be open, sit down and talk about it in the family. If there are needs to be spent upon, sit down together and talk about it. Number two, educate yourself about money management. Study the principles of spending money. You say, where can I study that? The book of Proverbs talks about money so much. You say, where else can I study about that? The parables of Jesus Christ. You see, two thoughts of the parables of Jesus Christ talk about money. Where else can I study that? Because in the Old Testament, there is mention about, you know, family living together, spending together, rejoicing together, agreeing together, and, you know, learning together. Many, many things you can learn. Study the principles of spending money, about money management. Study on budgeting.
And
budgeting means, you know, before you ever spend the money, you sit down, you say, what do we actually need? And then you see how to make the budget to meet, you know, the financial demand on the family. Study about spending. Now, those of us who are working in offices, let me ask you. Have you ever studied about paying tax? Oh, you say, that's the problem of the government. No, it is your problem. Have you ever filled any form on, you know, paying your tax? If you don't pay any form, the government will be taking the highest amount from you. Before you fill the form, talk to people who understand, who know how to fill that form. Sit down together with your wife and study on budgeting, spending, taxes, and investments. No, you go to your friend and you see that your friend has a poultry at the back, you know, of the house. Without ever discussing with your wife, you come back home and you say, well, I'm going to spend some money on raising up a poultry. Before your wife knows what is happening, the carpenters have come, they have built the thing, you have got to, you know, you have gone to get chicken, and they are all there. And you bought 300, before the next week, 100 of them have died. Then you call your wife and say, ah, what's the problem? The thing you should have done before to discuss, you now want to discuss. Study together on saving, on credit, many things you can study about with your wife, with your husband. Number three, avoid debt like sickness. What is debt? When the sum total of what you owe is more than the sum total of what you have, what you own, that is, you are in the red, you are in debt. How can we avoid debt? Already, if you are owing some amount of money, sit down to plan how you will pay back. If possible, talk to the person you are owing. Tell him you will not not be able to pay everything just at once, will be paying instrumentally. If that is not possible, if he says, I want everything all together, telling my brother, my sister, or you know where, my uncle, I do not have all the money right now. Look at the money that comes into you. If you are owing, let's say, 300 naira, by self-control, by self-discipline, will I be able to pay 60 naira every month? And the man says, and you know you can do that. But the man says, I don't want 60 naira every month, just give me all the 300. That will take you 5 months. You say, okay, give me chance. The first month, you put 60 naira aside. You know, that is not your money. It's like you have paid it back. You will never touch it. Second month, you add the 60 naira. Third month, add the 60 naira. At the end of the 5 months, you have 300 naira to go and pay to that man. Do you know what happens when you have paid all your debt? The heavy load on your head is lifted. The fear that comes to your heart when you see the man you are owing money, that fear goes away. The bondage that makes your house a prison yet for you, the bondage is taken away. The joy that has gone away from you because of the debt, that joy will come back. You'll be happy. You will be a free citizen of Nigeria. You will not say, who is that one coming? Am I at home? Now, my children, do you think I'm at home now? What will you tell that man when he comes? There will be no necessity of that when you have paid all your debt. And when you see the person at the Bible study, at the fellowship, and the usher said, brother, sit down here. On that row is that man that you owe money. You take it, you say, I'm going to the toilet for. Then you get to the toilet. When you are coming from the toilet, you go to the other side so you don't see that man. You see, after you have paid all your debt, there will be total freedom from your heart. Now agree on a family priority list and stick to it. You see, that means to sit down with your wife, with your Bible in your hand. Now you ask your wife, now my wife, this month you'll be a new month. What do we need in this house for this month? Your wife says, such and such. Such and such. Such and such. Such and such. Then you say, but have you forgotten this? Oh, yes, we need that thing. And then you write a long list of what you need for this month. That's not the end. You say, my wife, now, which is number one, the most important, that if we don't have, we just can't do without. You are rearranging the list of what you have written down from the most important, the urgent, the one that is, you know, just important, you just cannot do without, so the one that are less important. You must decide that before you ever go to the market. You know, what happens to us is that we take a salary. And while we are taking a salary, you have 300 naira in the pocket. And you say, I need something. You are not treating those things now. You go to Kingsway, you go to Chalaram, you go to the market, you go to supermarket, and you are going out like a big man. And then all the people are saying, come, buy, come, buy, come, buy. Before you come back, 300 naira is gone. And then it's also you have bought all those things. Yeah, but I think I need this one, I didn't remember. I didn't buy this one. Before you ever get out of the house, decide what you need before you go and buy. Don't ever go and visit a large shop with money in your pocket if you have not decided what to buy. You cannot go to market and not see what to buy. Even when you don't need it, you will buy the toy. You will buy ball. You will buy sunshade. You will buy
shirt.
You will buy slippers. You will forget that gari is important, but there's no gari in the market you have gone. That's why you mustn't just foolishly go to the market with all your money in your pocket. Leave the money behind and then decide on what you actually need. Now, how do we make budget? Now, this is the steps you need to take in making a budget. The money is in your hand, now you want to buy. Number one, what do we have coming in each month? What is the monthly take home pay that comes to the family? Besides that, number two, what are the fixed expenses on house rent, instrumental paying, on food, household spending, on the car maintenance, on transportation, on the tithe, on the little amount you also save for the near future? I'm going to give you some figures, therefore we're ready to rise. After you are taking away your tithe and the tax has been removed, now you break the money that remains with into three sections. 10%, that is 1 out of 10, should go for saving for emergency or whatever spending I may have unknowingly in the future. 10%. Then 20%, 2 out of 10, will go for the debt that you owe. Because you see, if you don't plan about paying the debt will be there all the time. But if you are paying it little by little by little, eventually everything will go. Then it is 70%, 7 out of 10 parts that will go for the regular living expenses. It's called the 10-20-70 system of spending. The financial counselor say that this is the best way of spending. After you have removed your tithes and you have paid your tax to the government, all that remains, you don't spend everything that remains. 10% for savings, 20% for debt, 70% for your normal, regular living expenses. Now, what's left then for the variable expenses? When you take away your total monthly fixed expenses from the total monthly income, all that remains is for variable spending. You know, giving this man this and helping this other one, doing this little thing over there. Now, you must also sit down to discuss in budgeting how do we now reasonably and wisely spend what is available for the family. Now you see, I'm very concerned about our families and how we spend money, because it's not only for married people. Many times our young brothers and young sisters have started a business and they have not been able to get on well. They can sell, they can work, they can trade, they can have money, but because they don't know financial management, the businesses are crumbling all the time. Money is a tool for the provision of our needs. Money is a tool for sharing blessings with other people. Money is a tool to be able to provide satisfactorily for the needs of a family. Don't let it become your master. Have wisdom in spending, and then you'll be able to reach the goal of financial freedom in your life. Have you got anything today? Let's rise up and pray. Whatever we have learned, let us bring it to the Lord.
We
tell the Lord we are sorry for the foolish spending of the past. Now we want to be spending wisely in such a reasonable way to be profitable for the family. If you don't have money, talk to God about it. He'll provide for you. If you have, think and plan and study about how to spend.